In a plane. In this chapter, we will study about those physical quantities which are moving in a plane or the object whose position is given by two coordinates. It can be xy coordinates, yz or zx coordinate. Now, as we know that physical quantities are of four types. One is a scalar, another is vector, third one is ratio, and the fourth one is tensor. In that, we already studied that a scalar has only magnitude and vector quantities have magnitude as well as direction. In ratio, it has only number and it's unitless. In tensor, there are number of directions at different positions. And tensor is not in our course, so we'll not study it. Ratio is a number only, unitless also. Vector gives us direction along with its magnitude, and scalar has only magnitude. This we know. Now here we will study about the differences between these scalar and vector quantities in detail, and which are important one. And as we know that physical quantity, if it is moving in a straight line and if it is a vector quantity, the physical quantity, if it's a vector, it gives us direction, and if it is moving in a straight line, then its direction can be given by either x-axis or positive axis or negative axis. That is, it can be in positive x-axis, it can be in positive y-axis, and in positive z-axis, or negative x, negative y, and negative z-axis. But if the physical quantity is moving in a plane or a space, and if it is a vector, that is, its position is given by two coordinates or three coordinates in three-dimensional, then there is a need of a vector to give its direction. Let's study about it. Let us suppose in a xy plane, an object is moving. It starts from origin and its position is, let's suppose, P. And after that, so we can see that this is the length and this is the distance the object has covered, and its direction is along OP. And it's not a particular direction, so we cannot say that it's moving in particular X direction or it's in particular Y direction. And if the object, after a time being, it is at some position, that is, let us suppose P dash is the position, and now the direction is along PP dash. So the total displacement of a particle is OP dash, and its direction is along P dash. So in order to find its direction OP dash, we use vector, because we cannot say that it is in positive x-axis or it is in particularly x-axis or in y-axis. So there is a need of vector. So let's study about the differences of scalar and a vector quantity. First one, we all know that scalar quantity has only magnitude, that is, it is given by a number only, and vector has both magnitude and direction, number as well as direction. The second one is, if the magnitude changes, then it will change. It changes with change in magnitude. But it changes if either there is a change in magnitude or in direction, or there is a change in both. if change in either magnitude or in direction or in both. We can add it by using ordinary rules of algebra. It can be added or subtracted also. We can add or subtract same units. By ordinary rules of algebra. That is, we can add all the positives, we can add all the negatives. But we cannot add it by ordinary rules of algebra. For addition and subtraction. So let's see example of this, point number 3. If we want to add five newton force with 6 newton, then it will give us total 11 newton force. But if here 5 newton force in x direction, so it's given by 5 newton I cap, and then the force is in y direction, so it's given by 6 newton j cap. Then if we want to add it, so it can be given by 5 newton in x direction and 6 newton in y direction. So their resultant will be this, and it is given by, let us suppose it is O, B, and this is A. So OB here equal to 5 square plus 6 square. That is equal to 25 plus 36, that is 61. Root of 61 is the answer here. We can represent this scalar quantity by ordinary letters. Represented by simple letters like power, work, and here we represent it by bold faced letter or letters having arrow over the physical quantity. That is, if we want to represent force, so we know that force is a vector quantity, so it can be written in this way, it can be written in this way, that is F vector. Here, this arrow is represented by this starting point is known as tail, and this final point is known as head. Its magnitude is given by F vector magnitude, or simply we can write F. That is, if we will write it in an ordinary way, then it will denote its magnitude. So this is the differences. These all are the differences between scalar and vector quantities, but there is one important note. If any physical quantity having both magnitude and direction, then it can be scalar. If any physical quantity having both magnitude as well as direction, then it can be a scalar quantity if it's not following law of vector algebra. That is triangle law of vector addition or the rules of vector algebra. For example, time, current, both are scalar quantity even though they show direction because they are not following the rules of vector algebra. That is, we know that the current starts from positive electrode and ends at negative electrode. Thus, it has same direction throughout. But in vector algebra, if the vector is showing direction in same direction, then the resultant will be in opposite order. That is, its resultant will be shown by different direction, that is, which is opposite to the given vectors. So here, current is flowing, let us suppose in this way, but the resultant is not opposite to that. Thus, it is not following the rules of vector algebra. Similarly with the time. Now, types of vectors. Basically, there are two types of vectors. One is polar vector and the other one is axial vector. What do you mean by polar? First is polar vectors. Polar vectors are those which are having their starting point or the point of application, and it acts along the direction of motion. That is, these are those vectors which have its starting point of application. We can understand it with the help of examples. So, or it acts along the direction of motion. Of a body. Examples are displacements, force, velocity, linear momentum. These all are polar vectors. Displacement has its initial point or a point of application, and it acts in the direction of motion. Its direction is along the direction of motion, then we can say that it's a polar vector. And force, similarly, force has also its direction is along the direction of motion. Velocity also similar, we can say linear momentum is the product of mass into velocity. So as the velocity is a polar vector, because it is in a direction of, its direction is along the motion. So we can say that it's a polar vector. Second one is axial vector. Axial vectors are those vectors whose directions is directions are along the axis of rotation of a body. That is, let us suppose this is a disc and perpendicular to the plane, this disc has a vertical axis, and when this disc is rotating with some velocity, that is, it has some angular velocity. When we will apply some force, then this will start rotating. Then the angular velocity direction will be given by this axis, its vertical axis. And this is angular velocity, omega. As it's a vector, it's given by this angular velocity. If we are applying some force, then we can also denote it that there is a rotational motion because we are giving a required centripetal force, and there is a some rotational motion. So this is a force and its direction is given by torque. This also we will study it in detail, that what do you mean by torque and what is force? What is the difference between torque and force? We will study it. So here we can see that axial vectors are those whose directions are only given by the axis of its rotation, not along the axis. So these kinds of vectors are known as axial vectors. Their examples are angular velocity, angular acceleration denoted by alpha vector, angular acceleration, torque, angular momentum, etc. These